My name is Mahmoud Suleiman. I am a professor of teacher education at California State University, Bakersfield, in California. And my grant was during the year 2009-2010 in the area of teacher education, and my host country is the Kingdom of Bahrain. The focus of my grant was a combination of teaching and research, where I was engaged in a variety of activities, helping the BTC, the Bahrain Teachers College, working with colleagues and administrators to help meet the state initiative's expectations regarding teacher quality. So I was part of an academy which consists of a series of workshops for vice principals. I developed a series of workshops and implemented a lot of those to help vice principals and administrators basically improve the instructional practices at their school site. I also worked with candidates and worked with them on some ways to develop a knowledge and skill base and compile a portfolio that reflects their knowledge and skill base based on the Ministry of Education expectations and the national standards they have regarding teacher quality, and in order to be qualified to reach out to the children in the K-12 system. Fulbright has always been in the back of my mind, and throughout my professional years I wanted to apply, but I never got the chance to because I was running a program, and then I was a department chair, and you know that doesn't allow much time for research and grant writing and everything else that goes with it. So spring 2008 I stepped down as a department chair, and then I got into the application process because I wanted to take advantage of that opportunity to promote my knowledge and skill base beyond the professional routine that you do for a while, basically. So it was a great opportunity, and I found it to be extremely rewarding. My advice is basically to get on with the application process. I'm the kind of person who really get terrified from the paperwork and, you know, filling out rigid forms and going through each line, each box, each field, and so on. But once I got into the online website for the Fulbright in the State Department, it was really well organized, very intuitive, and it was really fun to complete, and you didn't have really to complete it in 1 hour or 2 hours. You can take a break and come back to it and so on. So I encourage everyone to seize that opportunity. In fact, I have been talking to my students and my colleagues and encouraging them to apply and take advantage of this opportunity, because it is a prestigious thing to have. So it was extremely helpful, the information that was put on the website and the hands-on support you get from colleagues like yourself and the professional staff at the State Department who really hold your hand and answer every question there is. The application process is extremely easy, very intuitive, and very rewarding, in fact, because it gives you an opportunity to update your resume and reflect about what you take for granted about your knowledge and skill base. Living in a different culture is always rewarding. Myself, you know, when I came to the States back in the mid-80s, I have found living outside your own culture is a rewarding process, because you actually get out of the prison of your own background, knowledge, and skill, and social circle, and everything else, and you experience a process of gain and loss. You know, you're away from family and from your home country, and so on and so forth. But the gain outweighs everything else, and it is extremely rewarding to become part of a different society, because you get exposed to another global reality that would be impossible otherwise. And living in the Kingdom of Bahrain, I have been fortunate to interact with people who are different from me, people who come from different walks of life, people who come from different cultures. It's a cross bridge for a lot of international trade, cultural and social events and educational events. So it's a remarkable opportunity for me that has actually contributed to my understanding of what it means to be a human, and it did promote an understanding for myself trying to understand others who are different from me. So I don't think that you can get that reward easily otherwise, unless you really take the risk that is worth taking, and then try it out, and it's a win-win process. And finally, I would like to thank all the support from the people of Bahrain and the State Department and the U.S. Embassy and the wonderful staff and administrators who run the Fulbright project. They do an excellent job during the pre-departure orientation and post the departure orientation, and throughout the residency. They are always for you, they always look for you, and they always make sure that you get all the support you need.